Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing well. Welcome to our EBS class. My dear students, you know that we have learned our second lesson from EBS 1. Alright, what is the name of lesson? Yes, very good. The name of lesson is Family as First School. Alright, we have learned different things in this lesson. Do you remember what we have learned? Yes, very good. We have learned about different habits and values. Okay, we have also learned how habits and values differ in family. Then we have discussed about habits and values in my family or in your family. Okay, and we have also learned about most important thing, that is good habit and bad habit. Now in today's session, we are going to solve some questions related to this lesson. Are you ready, students? So open your EBS workbook part 1 and let us start with the question and answers. Alright, see, the first question is from section I remember. Alright, and what is the question? The question is multiple choice questions. So first question is, what are habits? Do you know that? What are habits? What is mean by habits? Very good. Habits are nothing but the activities which we do daily. So here option B is the answer. Alright. So here, what are habits means the habits are nothing but activities which we do daily. Alright. Then second question is, with whom do we live? With whom do you live? Yes, very good. We live with our family members. Can you tell me some family members? Yes, our parents, grandparents, uncles, aunts, siblings and cousins. These are our family members. So here, with whom do we live? So the answer is option number C, that is family members. Alright, now let us move toward the next question. The next question is fill in the blanks. In this, we have third fill in the blank as we learn different habits and dash from our family. Now, as we know that there are different habits and we learn all the things from our family members. So, here we learn different habits and dash. So, what will come here? Yes. What is the name of our lesson? Yes. So, here values from our family member. We learn different values, different habits from our family members. Then, fourth one is taking care of younger one is a good dash. So here, to be kind, taking care of younger one, taking care of elder person, respecting elder, what is these all things are? Yes, these all things are good values. So here we'll write value as taking care of younger ones is a good value. Now let us see short answer questions. Very short answer questions. Here you have to write answer very short. So the fifth question is, name anyone good habit. As I told you, there are different good habits such as respecting elders, then doing our things on the time. So here, morning walk, having breakfast on time. These are the good habit. Alright, the question is, name anyone good habit. Alright, so here we have to write any good habit that you have or that your family member have, which is nothing but morning walk, exercising, waking up on the time, completing your things on time. Alright, so here you will write morning walk, having breakfast on time or completing your work on time, that is homework. Alright, then sixth one is, name a value we should keep in mind while talking to elders. Alright, while talking to elders, what thing which we have to keep in mind? Yes, very good. We have to respect them. While talking with elders, we have to respect them. We have to talk with them with respect. Alright, so here, while talking with the elders, we have to respecting elders. Alright. Then next question is very short answer question. Here, what are values? You have to write meaning of values. Do you know what is mean by values? Yes, the values are nothing but good actions and good thoughts. Alright, here values are good actions and good thoughts. Then values help us to decide what is right and what is wrong. Alright, how that values help us? Values help us to decide what things are right and what things are wrong. Alright, understood? Now let us see next question. The next question is from the section I understand, that is true or false. Alright, here you have to read the statement and you have to write true or false, whether the statement is true or false. Alright, so the 8th number statement is, in some families, the family members touch the feet of elders. As I told you, there are different values in different families. So some families, while respecting elders, they touch the feet of elders and they also stand up when elders enters into the room. Alright, so the statement is true. Okay, then 9th number. Our family does not take care of us when we are sick. We learn habits from our family as well as values from our family. In that, I told you, our each family member, they take care of us when we are ill or when we need help of them. This thing teaches us to be kind and to be helpful. Alright, so this statement, it is given here, our family does not take care of us. When you are ill, that time is happening in your family, that your mother and father, they don't take care of you. No, this statement is false, because our family members, they take care of us. Alright, when we are ill, they take us to the doctor, they give medicines us on time. Alright, so this statement is false. Then 10th statement is, parents talk to elders with respect. Yes, we all know that while talking with elders, we have to keep one thing in our mind, that is respecting elders. And these things we learn from our parents, as our parents, they talk to elders with respect. Alright, so this statement is true. Then statement number 11, that is, our parents get up early and do the household work. Yes, as I told you, discipline. In discipline, what we have to do? We learn these things from our family members. As if our family members wake up on time and they do their work on time, so we also learn same manners or same discipline manners. Okay, so here the statement is true. Alright, then next question, we'll read it. Short answer questions. Here, question number 12 is, name some eating habit that we learn from our family members. There are different habits which we learn from our family member. In that, we also learn different eating habits from our family members, as table manners, way of eating, or the way of food which we like. Alright, these things we learn from our family members. So here, we learn to prefer eating certain types of food. Means, if the family members, they love to eat vegetarian food, then we also eat such type of food. Alright, if some families, they prefer to non-vegetarian food, then we also love to eat non-vegetarian food. These things, these habits we get from our family members. Then, we learn to eat in a particular way. Yes, we learn the greeting day in a particular manner from our family members. Then here we also learn different table manners from our family members. Alright students, then now let us see question number 13. Okay, how do people respect elders in some families? Here we have to write how the family members they respect elders, alright, which are there in their families. So here, in some families, people stand up when elder person enters into the room. Then some people touch the feet. Okay, some people touch the feet of elder and talk to them with respect. Alright, understood? Here, in some families, how people give respect to elders? Yes, they stand up when elder person enters into the room. Then, while the festival or something, they touch the feet of elder members which are there in their family. And they also, while talking with the elders, they give them respect. Alright students, let us move toward the next question. That is question number 14. Here, you have long answer question. What we have to do here? Let us read. Write the values you learn from this statement given below. Here some statements are given. And here you have to write values which we learn from this statement. Understood? So here options are given. Means the values are given. We have to just read this statement. And we have to just write one option from these values. Alright? So the first one is, your parents wake up on time. What thing we learn from this? Very good. As our parents, they do all the things on time. These things help us to be in discipline. So here we write discipline. Alright. Then option B. Your parents stand up when elders enter into the room. What? Here? Yes. Respecting others. This thing teach us values such as respecting others. Alright. Then here option C, statement C. Your family takes care of you. As I told you, when we are sick, that time our family members, our parents, they take care of us. So this thing teach us to be helpful and to be kind. Alright. So here kind and helpful will be the answer. Let us move toward the next question. Here, statement D. Your family prays before meal. We have to pray before each meal. Alright, in some families, this habit is there. So, what this thing teaches us? Yes, this thing teaches us to be in discipline. Then, E statement is, your parents listen to their parents. Means, what? Yes, respecting others. If we respect our family member, we listen their everything. Alright, so our mother and father, they listen to their parents. Okay, and this thing teach us respecting elders. This value is respecting elders. Then F1 is, your family keeps their footwear outside the house. As we know that we have to keep footwear outside the house. This is nothing but discipline. Alright. We behave in a disciplined manner while removing our shoes. So we keep those shoes outside. Alright. Here your parents touch the feet of elders as he gives respect to elders. Alright. So here respecting others. Which value is this? Respecting others. Then here your sister helps you in your studies. As I told you, your sister or your elder sister, your parents, they always help you to complete your homework. So this thing teach us kind and helpful, to be kind and helpful. Alright, let us move toward the next question. That is question number 15 from the section I apply. Your multiple choice question is there. Alright. So, 15 number question is which one of the following is a good value? Your multiple choice question is here. We have to read these options, alright, and we have to choose a good value, alright. The first is helping old people to cross the road. Then not obeying teachers, teasing friends, shouting at elders. Are these good habits? No. The first one, only option A, that is helping old people while crossing the road. This thing is a good value. So here option A will be the answer. Then here 16 number question. Who helps to run the school? Do you know that? There are different people who help us to run the school, such as school principal, teachers, then helpers, alright. They all help us to run our school. So here the option, doctor? No. Lawyer? No. Police? No. The correct option is principal. Alright, so your answer will be option D. Alright, now let us move toward the question number 17. The question number 17 is a short answer question. Here, which member of your family do you respect the most? You have to write which person in your family you respect the most, and you also write here what good habit would you like to learn from him or her. As if you are going to write your mother, I respect my mother the most, alright. So you have to write here, I would like to help others as the way she does, alright. Our mother, she always helps us and other family members. This thing we learn from our mother, alright, that to be helpful and kind. Okay, so you can write here in this way. If your father, they always respect elders, you can write here, I respect my father the most as I would like to respect others the way he does. Alright, understand? Now let us move toward the next slide. That is question number 18. Here what you have to do? Yes. Which of the following picture shows a good value and why? Here, observe this picture A and picture B. Here, the children, they are cleaning. And here, these two boys, they are fighting with each other. Can you tell me which picture is showing good habit? Yes, picture A. This picture is showing good habit as they are cleaning the floor and these two boys, they are fighting. Is this a good habit? No, this is not a good habit. So here we write picture A shows a good value because the children are helping each other and trying to keep the place clean. Alright, what you have to write? Picture A shows a good value because the children are helping each other and trying to keep the place clean. Alright, understood? Okay, now let us see next question. Here, the next question is question number 19, which is long answer question. Here, you have to observe the picture and the things which help you to keep your classroom clean. Alright. The first one, throw garbage in the dustbin. Alright. Here always, your teacher always tells you to throw anything. That is, when you sharp the pencil, teacher tells you to throw that in the dustbin. Alright. So, throw garbage in the dustbin. Then, do not spoil food or water. We should not spoil food or water. Then keep the blackboard clean when not in use. We have to keep a blackboard always clean when it is not in use. Then do not write on the walls. There are beautiful walls in our school. We have different pictures on it. Alright. So we should not write anything on the wall. It makes our class dirty. Okay. So here, do not write on the walls. The next one. Here, the question number 20. Long answer question. You have to read first column, second column and third column. Alright, in the first column there are different pictures given. Here some bad habits are given and in the third column some good habits are given. Alright, we have to match each thing with the correct picture. Okay, so here we will see picture A. Picture A is showing sleeping in the class. Alright, that first boy, he is sleeping in the class. So this is a bad habit. So what is the good thing which is related to the picture? We should be attentive in the class and should not sleep. When your teacher is teaching, that time you should sleep in the class. No, you should not sleep in the class. You should be attentive. What is your teaching? You should listen to it carefully. Alright, it helps you to learn new things. Okay students, so here B1, B picture is coughing without covering the mouth. It is one bad habit. Alright, see here, coughing without covering the mouth. We know that now it is compulsory to us to wear mask because of corona pandemic. So this is the most important thing. Alright, here you should, now we will read good habit to related this picture, that is we should cover our mouth while coughing or sneezing. Here in the option C the word out is given. Alright, it is one printing mistake. So here you should write R, O-U-R. Alright, we should cover our mouth while coughing or sneezing. Then picture C. See here, picture C, that boy, he throws the garbage on the road. So you are throwing garbage on the road or on the ground. This is the bad habit. Alright. And now we will read good habit related to this. As we already know that whenever we want to throw something, where we have to throw it? Yes, we should throw garbage in the dustbin. Okay students. Then see picture D, which is leaving the tap running while brushing teeth. Is it a good habit? No. Wasting water is one of the most bad habit. Alright. So here whenever you are in the school, while you are recess time, you went to wash your hands. That time many students, what do they do? Yes, they keep the tap open. Okay. So here this is bad thing, that leaving the tap running while brushing teeth. Now let us read good habit which we have to do related to this picture, that is we should close the taps while brushing the teeth. Alright, the time when you brush your teeth, that time you should not run out that tap. You have to close it. Alright, then brush your teeth and whenever you want to wash your mouth, that time you can put on it. Alright. So, I hope you all have understood all the question and answer which I have explained in today's session. Alright students, thank you.